Hello, welcome to Ludic Science. We have another video on the high voltage capacitor bank, and today I want to try to crush an aluminum can, soda can, with the magnetic power generated by this coil when all the energy in the capacitor bank is released into the coil. As in my previous videos, I am using the same setup, the lab power supply that powers the capacitor charger, which is a high voltage power supply. This charges the capacitor bank, which is 850 microfarads at 100 volts. And then we have the spark gap switch to release the energy of the capacitor bank into the coil. I have videos where I built each of these components. One for the capacitor charger, another video for the capacitor bank, and another one for the spark gap switch. In the description of this video, you have the links if you want to check those videos. Next time you need a PCB for your electronics project, consider using the professional services of JLC PCB. JLC PCB is the world leader in PCB fabrication. You can order online. You just need to register, upload your Gerber file, and wait a few days for your PCBs at an unbeatable price. The working principle is that when we release all the energy stored in the capacitor bank into the coil, a very intense magnetic field is generated. And this magnetic field induces in the can a current because the can is a conductor. The current generates its own magnetic field. And we know because of Lenz's law that the magnetic field of the can is opposed to the magnetic field that created, that is the magnetic field of the coil. So we will have a repulsion between the can and the coil, and therefore there will be a force trying to push the can to the center. The magnetic field is very high because we are releasing all the energy of the capacitor in just a fraction of a second. And as you know, power is energy divided by time, and the time is very small, so the power is very, very high. When you have a large enough energy in the capacitor bank, you can even break the can in two. However, my capacitor bank is only 350 joules of energy, so I'm not sure if I will succeed. So let's try to see if we can make any damage to the can. You may be wondering why I have only 3 turns in the coil. Why not use more turns in order to increase the magnetic field? And the reason is that if you add more turns to the coil, you increase the inductance, and a large inductance will have the effect to slow the release of the energy. And if the time is larger, the power will be smaller. Therefore, we need a coil with just a few turns in order to increase the power. Okay, so let's charge our capacitor bank until it reaches around 800 volts and see what happens. Okay. Well, that was a total fail. The can is almost intact, just some very small wrinkles in here. They are barely visible, and that means that the energy in the capacitor bank is not enough to crush this can. So let me try with something softer to see if we can succeed. Well, at least with thin aluminum foil, we were able to see the effect of the magnetic force. As you can see, the diameter has shrunken here where the coil was placed because of the force that points to the center of the cylinder. And this is the effect that I wanted to show you. Well, that's all for today's video. I hope you liked the demonstration of magnetic force. Thanks for visiting my channel and see you in the next video.